The population of Clarkston is about 12,000 people. It's the most diverse square mile in America. The best thing about Clarkston is that they have about 50 different countries and 70 languages are spoken. We all come together at the end of the day and we share a lot of similarities even though we are different. My name is Oba Afwerki. I was born to an Eritrean father and an Ethiopian mother. When I came to Clarkston, I was about 9 or 10 years old. The biggest difference now is that like the kids, they have more opportunities. For example, growing up, there was no hope for you to become professional. But right now, soccer in Clarkston is becoming accessible. Like for example, Atlanta United is looking for players in Clarkston. All the team in Georgia is looking for players in Clarkston. Some colleges are looking for players here because Clarkston is a place for talent.
It's 5:26 right now. Practice start at 4. It's supposed to start at 4, but the coaches come 4:30, so.
What do you like about coaching?
I like the fact that I could socialize with the girls and interact with them and, you know, we can work together as a team and the sky's the limit for them and I want to show them that they're not limited to anything and that if they want something, they have to work for it.
All the jobs, their job with them. Okay, guys? I need you guys, even if you're not going to get the ball, at least you're there for support, you know? You're there as an option. Again! There you go!
Starting just last year, we were really, really bad, like really bad. I was contemplating on whether or not I want to coach anymore, but I had a lot of hope with them.
Talk about what you like about being a coach.
Well, being a coach is my passion always since I was 5 years old. I love soccer, which is only sport that we've been playing in Africa, so we call football. When you come to the United States, they say soccer. And soccer is the language that we're speaking. You know, I know a lot of them are speaking so many different languages, and some of them, I don't even understand what they be saying, but you know, one language we have is the soccer.
Growing up in the refugee camp was hard. I didn't really have a childhood. I had to be matured at an early age. And playing soccer in Clarkston was not easy because some of the fields were off limits to us. We just played street soccer most of the time, or we played pickups and have like 2 rocks as a goal, and then we just have fun then.
I just feel the one struggle that these kids face at this age is just fitting in with everybody else around them. Each and every one of these kids, I see the ambition to wanting to learn. They wake up every day just wanting to learn.
Hello! We're recording a video and you're speaking.
You recording?
Sorry.
Okay, that's fine.
Oh, sorry. go fast.
So I started playing soccer from watching my brothers play, and soccer like runs through my family, and it's basically like a gift from God. I've been a part of CSC for at least like a year, and when I first came to the Clarkston Football Club, I just like came here to start watching my friend play. I just practiced with them, and I realized that I started playing better than before.
It's not. Yeah, it's not so.
You still recording?
Of course. Always.
We lost every like game last year, and then we come over here after intense training, intense practice, and you know, mingling with the teammates and all that stuff to just win every game undefeated this whole season. It's a very big change, and I feel very proud.
What's up, man?
How are you?
How you doing?
Good.
What was it like coming to the US?
We had to wait a lot. Like, basically, we started registering to come here since I was like 5. But then they answered finally when I was around 11 or 12.
What do you remember about your country?
I remember a lot, like my friends, my people, and the street food.
I don't remember much about my country because I left when I was 9 years old. Well, technically, I left when I was 5 because we had to move to camps so that we could work on coming to the United States. And from what my parents tell me, that we basically never slept in our house, like most of the times, because we were always on the run, always in the woods, running from wars and stuff.
Yeah, don't get on my bad side.
In each of every country, you're not proud, you're well made, but if you're not accepted, you feel as an outcast.
Santino is like my brother. He's the most humble person I had ever met. He gave everything to the kids, and most of these kids, you know, it wasn't for him. I don't know where they would be.
Am I good? You see me?
Yes. What is your name?
Oh. My name is Obai.
I mean, what can I say? The most diverse square mile in the United States. Of course, you have an inch of every country. And with that comes a talent.
Can you explain the struggles that the kids might face?
I'm honestly not. I haven't been sharing stories like that with them. But as far as struggle is just adjusting to this country, as far as coming out from our own homeland, you know? They don't feel that they belong here. So they try so hard to fit in with everybody else, and sometimes that takes them the wrong path.
Hey, hold on, sorry. Timu, you think I don't see you?
Yeah, tell him the camera.
Sorry.
Man, taking the kids to the Atlanta United game was like the most beautiful thing I've seen.
Who wants some good news?
It's Philadelphia. It's easy game.
They play a good team.
Okay, you play defense or not?
Who do you think is going to win?
Maybe Atlanta. I've been playing Philadelphia.
Yeah.
They're going to win because I already watched. They lost.
To be honest, I think Atlanta is going to lose.
And I
expecting Martinez to score.
How many points did you see him score?
At least a hat trick.
I connect very well with the kids because I see myself in them. Some of them are like my little brothers or little sister. I see the struggle that they go through every day. When they play soccer, I see the smile. I see like taking all the anger on the field. One wrong turn can change your life. I see a lot of great things in these kids. And I can't wait for the future.
I never sleep, no restin'. I'm still awake, I'm good. True man, always on the cellular. I got plans, I got my cellular. But nothing.